We have a built-in desire to explore.
It's our curiosity which has led us to where we are.
This inner drive makes us look for the unknowns in terms of knowledge.
Autonomous systems can help us making sense of the world.
I definitely see autonomous systems helping smarter farming, higher crop yields.
Hey, there is some kind of chemical plant. It's throwing a lot of methane in the air. It can help us to pinpoint the polluters. Hopefully that also makes us more sustainable.
And there is no other technology that can do that as well as microelectronics can do it.
Look out at that horizon and reach it farther than we can before.
I would say it is a calling to do something that no one else has done. See something that no one else has seen.
Discovering the unknown, to me, was looking up in the stars and studying the cosmos. And understanding the physics of the various mechanisms that govern our universe. But more and more I realized it is not in our ability, at least in our own lifetimes, to travel to these places and to see it from our own eyes.
Humans cannot explore most of the unknown environments, extreme environments. And these are places where we want to have systems which are autonomous.
They may give us access to different perspectives.
If you think of the deep sea space or deep into our brain, these are untreated territories. We have not been there.
We just made a needle prick in getting a bit of an idea of what is out there.
So to better understand our place in the big picture, yeah, you also have to look out.
Welcome to the moon. What you see here is Luna Zebra taking its first baby steps. And we are here focusing currently on autonomous intelligence. Autonomy for Luna Zebra means it knows where it is.
It knows it has to head towards a certain point B, and it doesn't know where the obstacles are, and so it learns on the go.
So the moon, at approximately 400,000 kilometers from us, is the closest cosmic rock. We now trust our systems that we designed to go explore the universe for us, and Luna Zebra is our tiny contribution to humanity along those lines.
This is the TU Delft Microelectronics weather vane of the future that uses microelectronic chips with no moving parts, but can get even better data than what you could get with something kind of like this. My, in particular, interest is in really harsh environments that need to be explored autonomously without risking the lives of humans there. So a good place to practice is up the roof. Things are out here outside all the time. We're exposed to wind up here all day, the hot sun. Electronics actually wouldn't like to hang out in this environment for too long. I'd say this is a stepping stone to going to even harsher environments, more remote. It'll enable us to take sensors to places that we currently can't explore with our modern technology. There's plenty of the world that we still haven't explored. Whatever that environment ends up being, it'll be one of the best days of my life if my sensor collected the data.
Places where we as humans have troubles thriving, I think those are the first places we should think about sending robots.
And they can continuously, even in real time, monitor environmental conditions.
We know less of our oceans than we know about the land.
There's so much still to uncover.
They should be starting to explore the human body. Same technology that they use for drones are used there.
Microelectronics and autonomous systems could be deployed anywhere and everywhere to measure the environment.
We first need to calibrate these things in a controlled climate environment. So this is our climate controlled chamber lab. This particular chamber has the capability of going from minus 40 degrees Celsius up to 160 degrees Celsius, which is a very large temperature range for several on-Earth industrial applications. We hope to see that the chip performs the way it did when we started. Looks like an insect waking up from hibernation in Antarctica. I think it's fun to see these chips in action and withstanding the heat or withstanding the cold. It's like watching your kids grow up. First, they have to crawl before they can walk and run. I'd say this is the crawling and early walking stages before we can let our chips loose in the wild.
Inaccessible, unknown environments also mean there is an absence of infrastructure. With a swarm, you can do a lot more in a certain mission lifetime as compared to a single agent, because they can collectively explore an area and give an idea of what that area contains. So they should rely heavily on their neighbors to communicate, to sense the environment, and to go from point A to point B. These drone dynamics and understanding their dynamics, and that's one of the key challenges. It's a wheel of learn and correct and learn and correct. Can I be safe? Can I know my position? Can I know my time? And lastly, can I execute a certain mission? Can the swarm assist human operations in discovering the unknown?
We don't know where the potential stops. It's about understanding ourselves and our world better.
Autonomous systems can help us in helping with our understanding how we are integrated. We are not the kings of the earth. We're part of the earth.
Microelectronics could help us to get rid of fossil fuels or to save power.
We need to show people it's possible and believe that we can improve these big problems we have in our world.
I would say let's keep on sensing.